Hey guys, I'm Oxy, and today I'm going to show you my bloody bow build early. Yes, because bow builds are finally viable in this game. So in this video I'm going to show you my build, the weapon and the armor and all the mutations, basically everything what I use for this build to work. First of all, we're going to start with some gameplay, and after I'm going to show you all my gear and everything. So we are at Vestech. Let's see how this build is gonna go. Do we have... Oh, we have actually a 3-star over there. Now let's see how this build is gonna do. I am strongest. I would say pretty good. Ah, we one-shot that guy. One-shot the other guy. One-shot this guy. Next, 900 damage, and we also get a level up, which is always welcome. Obviously one shot the doggo, level 75, one shot, 1000 damage. 3-star dog, obviously need more than one shot because it's legendary. Let's see what did he give us. Oh yeah, more level. Turret is down. Do we have? Yeah, we have one more. And it's down. Let's see what we did get. Where are the legendary? There. And of course we get nothing. And of course back the arrow. That's one of the best things about this build, because you can get back your ammunition pretty fast. It was another legendary here. That arrow back. Where was the other legendary? It was this one up here, right? And just another piece of garbage. So you already see how it's working again, super mutants. So now we're gonna check a tougher enemy. Alright, we're gonna go and kill Swan, but first let's see what we have here. Huh. So we have some floaters. They're good. Not bad. Is he dying from damage over time? Probably. Let's go after Swan. This is something really new, a bow build, and it's actually really really good. Oh, there you go, there's one. Let's go nice and close to him. That's not bad, 700 damage critical. That's 1500 damage. And one more. And almost done. Nice one. What is happening with you? Okay, thank you. And a couple of arrows back. That's another thing. Sometimes it's glitching out when you try to aim, and it's only going away if you put away your bow. Strange. Do we have scorpions? Yes, we have one. Let's see. So no more scorch here. Would you come here, please? Okay. Got her attention. Look at that. That's some damage over there. And critical. Ooh, got her mutated. Let's clear these guys out. Let's 1700 damage. And she's down. Clear these guys out. Stay down. And we are done. And we also got parasites. Wonderful. So yeah, not too bad. With a bow. So let's start with the mutations, guys. I have a lot of addictions here, exactly 5 addictions, because sometimes I run full health junkie bow, but you don't really need this if you want to go all the time bloodied. But sometimes, as I said, I'm doing full health with this character. Also parasite, which is not good at all. But these are the mutations. Adrenal reaction, you get more damage the lower your health is. Obviously we are a low health build. Burr bones for more agility and also reduce fall damage. Eagle eyes for more crit damage and more perception. Egghead for more intelligence, because that's really important these days with all the score and everything. Herbivore, because we are eating only vegetables. Those are giving us a lot of benefits like crit damage, more AP and things like that. Also marsupial for jumping and carry weight, that's obvious, that's a must have perk. And also speed demon for faster reload and faster move. Those are the mutations that I use for this build. Now let's start with the weapons. The weapon that I use, it's a bloodied compound bow modded with ultra seed arrows for more damage against scorch enemies and with the glow sight. Also have 50% more crit damage and plus 1 perception. This is a really, really, really good bow. I love this thing. Also, look at the damage, 340 after all the nerf that we get for bloodied. This is really, really good. The next weapon that I sometimes I use, it's also a bloodied prime crossbow. Again, prime frame iron sights. Obviously, this one have some nice damage also with crit damage and faster critical feel. I love these things. The only downside is the reload, it's too slow, just too slow. This is a backup weapon that I use sometimes, Junkie's Explosive, handmade with faster critical feel. I always use powerful automatic receiver, a line long barrel, a line grip, swift magazine and reflex sign to reduce the AP cost, and obviously suppressor. This is just a backup weapon, sometimes I use it. And one of the best crossbows that I have is this one, quad fast crit. So with this one I can have 4 arrows in one mag, which is really good. And also with the prime frame, it's pretty good. You can spam, you can do a lot of crit with this one. It's really, really good. I wish we would have bloodied quad, but that's impossible, but dreams. Okay, those are the weapons that I use. Let's see the armor. Armor is nothing special. Backpack. The backpack that I have, chemist mod, which you get from the raiders. You need to do wastelanders, you need to get reputation up with the raiders, and you can buy it for 350 gold or 300 gold if I remember. I'm not sure, it's been a while since I bought this backpack mod, and it's obviously really good. The backpack is just the small one, which is giving me plus 30 carry weight. Honestly, can't be bothered to get the normal backpack for 60 carry weight. 30 it's enough, it's easy to get. And yeah, let's start with Under Armor also. Shielded Long Jones, more perception, more agility, more luck. Obviously we need that, this is a VATS build. Now armor here is a little bit interesting. I use heavy combat armor with the shadow modification for obviously more stealth, and with dense to reduce the explosive damage from scorch beast sonic attack and other explosive attacks. I also have the ghillie combat torso paint job. This unyielding, obviously with low health, unyielding is perfect. It's giving you a lot of stat bonus, and AP refresh is always good. The next one is the same and the same and the same. It's all the same. on yielding AP refresh. Why it's so good on yielding? Just look at my stats. 6 strength. I know that's not much, but who cares about strength? Look at the perception, 37. Look at the agility, 34. And the luck, 27. That's a lot. No, I don't want to open it right now. And let's start with the build. We only need 2 strength, which is Bandolier to carry all the arrows that we have. Here in Perception, we have pretty standard Concentrated Fire for more VATS accuracy and all the Archer perks. And also Bow Before Me, which give you armor penetration and a little bit of chance to stagger. Also Fireproof to reduce even more explosive damage. Good doggy, that's just because I use canned dog food, it's really good. So Field Surgeon for Stim Packs to work much more faster. Now this perk, it's a must have in any type of build that you make. You need to have this one. Doesn't matter if you're bloodied or junkies or everything, full health, low health. Strange in numbers, obviously, to share all the stats, to share all the mutations. All the benefits from mutations are really good. Tenderizer for more damage. Nerd Rage, must have for this build, must have for every low health build. And Agility Action Boy for even more faster AP refill. Also Cover Operative for more sneak attack, sneak obviously to be sneaky. Escape Artist, must have to lose your enemies. Adrenaline, I only have it on 3, I don't think I need it on more. 350 damage, it's enough. Bloody Mass, it's not really a must have these days with all the nerf that got bloodied, but I still use it. Every little bit of damage is gonna help. Serendipity, because we are low health and that's helping us. Four Leaf Clover, because you did see in the video when I was doing a critical shot, that's a lot of damage, that's much more damage. So Four Leaf Clover, it's helping us to do some criticals sometimes. Strange Genes, because I want to keep my mutations. And Critical Savvy to use only 55% of our critical matter. Now let's go to the legendary perks. Legendary perks, I only have 2 slots unlocked on this character. I did take Funky Dudes because poison damage are awful for bloody builds. They're killing you very, very fast. So Funky Dudes is a must have on any type of bloody build. Also Follow Through, which is not really working. I heard it's not working with suppressed weapons. It doesn't look like it's working with bows. So I mean, it's maybe they're gonna fix it, I don't know, but that's all about. So yeah guys, this is my bloodied bow build. I hope you enjoy it, I hope you like it, I hope you're gonna try it, and see you guys in the next video.